Let's get some reaction to this and more. U.S. Senator Rand Paul is joining us. He's the Republican senator from Kentucky. He's a member of the Foreign Relations Committee and the Homeland Security Committee. Senator, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Wolf.
All right, so what's your reaction to what Elise just reported about Rudy Giuliani, the former New York City mayor? Do you think he would be a good Secretary of State?
Well, I think it is worrisome, some of the ties to foreign governments, because that was a big complaint about many of us with Hillary Clinton and her ties and the money she received from foreign governments. So whether or not you have divided loyalty obviously is very important. But I think more important than that is I think Trump should pick a Secretary of State that agrees with his foreign policy. And the thing Donald Trump said over and over again was that he was opposed to the Iraq war, and he learned that lesson that regime change in the Middle East was not a good idea. And yet, I don't see Giuliani coming out with statements like that. I certainly don't see John Bolton. I think both of them have been big cheerleaders for the Iraq war and for more intervention in the Middle East. So I hope Donald Trump will pick somebody consistent with what he said on the campaign trail. Iraq war was a mistake. Regime change in the Middle East is a mistake.
Because John Bolton, former U.S. ambassador to the U.N. during the Bush administration, I know you've written very, very sharp words criticizing him. You would be totally opposed. Would you go so far as not to vote to confirm him as Secretary of State if President-elect or President Trump goes ahead and nominates him?
I couldn't vote for Bolton unless he repudiated his support for the Iraq war and repudiated his support for regime change throughout the Middle East, repudiated his call for immediately bombing Iran. I mean, really, you want to have a diplomat in charge of diplomacy. You don't want a bomb thrower. And so, no, John Bolton's totally unfit to be Secretary of State. And I hope that the Trump administration will say, you know what, he does not represent what Donald Trump represents, which is change, and which is the understanding the Iraq war was a mistake and that regime change in the Middle East has been a mistake.
And Rudy Giuliani, what about him? Would you vote to confirm him?
You know, I think it's less clear. I think Giuliani shares most of John Bolton's statements towards Iran, towards the Iraq war. I'd say it's a stiff uphill climb for me with Giuliani because he'd have to convince me that he understands now the Iraq war was a mistake, and I've never heard anything like that coming from him. So really, I think Giuliani and Bolton are very similar. Bolton just has a more extensive cheerleading background with regard to war in the Middle East.
The other names we've heard, Newt Gingrich, the former Speaker of the House, we've heard his name, Richard Haass, the President of the Council on Foreign Relations, your colleague Bob Corker, the Chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. Quickly, give me your thoughts on them.
Any of them would be better than Giuliani or Bolton. I know Bob Corker well. He's not in exactly the same place as I am on foreign policy, but I would call him a realist. I would call him a reasonable person. I would call him a person who would seek peace as a first option rather than war, a steady hand, somebody who has, is thoughtful. And so, yeah, Corker would be way better than either Giuliani or Bolton. And if they feel like they have to give Giuliani a position, give him a position that doesn't put him in direct conflict with everything that Trump has said. He could be somewhere, but just don't put him in a position that would be in direct conflict to Donald Trump saying 1,000 times on the campaign trail that he was against the Iraq war.
We've heard some potential intelligence chief names be thrown out there. Let me put a few up on the screen. Retired Lieutenant General Michael Flynn, maybe a national security advisor to the president in the White House. He's a former head of DIA, the Defense Intelligence Agency. Retired Lieutenant General Ron Burgess for Director of National Intelligence. Former Michigan Congressman Pete Hoekstra, CIA director. He's a former chairman of the House Intelligence Committee. Are you familiar with them?
Yeah, I know all the names. I don't know them personally, but my question to anybody that wants to be in charge of our intelligence would be, will you defend the Fourth Amendment? Will you defend the American citizens' right to privacy? And will you try to do a better job at searching for the records of terrorists and less of a generalized sweep of all of our records? The one common theme to virtually every domestic terrorist attack has been that they've been investigated by the FBI before the attack, and the FBI has said, oh, they weren't a credible threat. So I think the FBI needs to reformat, reboot, and recharge how they do investigations. They need to be kept open longer, but they need to investigate terrorists, people for whom they have suspicion of terrorism, and not be grabbing up all the records of innocent Americans.
You've heard these reports that the president-elect is thinking maybe of asking the intelligence community to give top secret security clearances to his adult children, his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, who certainly emerged as a key advisor. Would you have a problem with that?
You know, I think you have to look at individuals. Just because they're related to someone doesn't make them ineligible for taking a high position. So, John Kennedy had Robert Kennedy in his cabinet. So I think we have seen people appoint people from their family. We've never seen children. But I'm not to say that it automatically excludes them. I think it depends on what they stand for, who they are, and they would have to be analyzed in that fashion. But I wouldn't make a comment saying no. I think we ought to look at the facts.
One final question, Senator, before I let you go. What do you think of Steve Bannon, the president-elect named him a senior counselor at the White House, senior advisor? What do you think of him?
You know, I think there's a lot of sour grapes out there. After people lose the election, they're pointing fingers. They're wanting to make him into a caricature. I've met him. I don't think he's a caricature of any of these horrible things the left is bringing out about him. I don't believe him to be a racist. I don't believe him to be anyone who categorizes anybody based on their race or otherwise or their religion. I think that that's a lot of just sour grapes. Let's give the guy a chance. Let's see how he performs. And really, I think it's the results we should look at. Look at what he says, where he is going moving forward, and judge that. But let's don't make him into a caricature just because people are unhappy about the election.
Senator, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Wolf.
Senator Rand Paul of Kentucky. More on the Trump transition coming up and details on